Webrazi izleyicileri merhabalar. Çok popüler olan girişim ofisleri programımızın yurt dışı ayı için Paris'teyiz. Paris'teki önemli internet firmalarını ziyaret edeceğiz birlikte. Yanımdaki binada Deezer ofisi bulunuyor. Deezer ofisinin önündeyiz. Avrupa'nın ve dünyanın çok yakında da en büyük müzik streaming servislerinden bir tanesi. Deezer'in ofisini birlikte gezelim. Bakalım nasıl bir ortamda çalışıyorlar.
I'm here with Mr. Matthew Molinero. He's the head of the new markets. Am I right?
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Yeah, exactly.
Thanks a lot, first of all, for accepting us. Yeah, in your
thank
office.
You for coming directly from Istanbul.
Thank you. And you're the head of the new markets.
Yeah.
What do you do?
Exactly. My goal is to identify the high potential markets where music streaming is ready to explore in these countries in order to identify these markets and to invest in these markets in order to launch them.
All know that Deezer is really preparing hard to open up to new continents
and markets. Yeah, exactly. But we have a dedicated there, for very big project dedicated team, and I'm really focusing on satellite countries where Deezer is open as a service, mm-hmm. but where we still haven't done much to make the brand very popular or to make some big partnerships with manufacturers or telecom carriers. Mm-hmm. And this is my role actually. So currently I'm really focusing on the big zone actually, the bigger area, from Scandinavia to go and challenge Spotify there, to Central Eastern Europe, Russia, Turkey, of course, and Southeast Asia.
And fun office, could you show us?
Yeah, of course. Awesome. We're really a music company actually. We didn't want to be only a tech company. We really wanted to make our DNA really part of music. And here on this wall, for example, you can see all the bands who went here to the office to shoot what we call the Deezer stations. Deezer stations are actually live performances shot directly here in the office. So we had big names just like Franz Ferdinand, like Lordi. We also have Agnes Obel who was here. So both international and French and local artists in different countries coming here. So it's very good, very fun.
This is the relaxation area, I believe.
Yeah, relaxation area, the cafeteria also, where everybody is gathering here to have lunch during the day. So we have a big table, just like in the old times, where all the family gathers. So here we are. In an important part of the office, because this is where the really top management key decision people are here. Our founder Dan Marilli, that's his office, and also our CEO. But they're currently not here, as you can see, because they're all in the US to prepare the launch for the end of the year. Mm-hmm. So this is why all the key top management has moved there for some time. And then, as you know, Deezer is really different from other streaming services where you focus a lot on editorial recommendations based on human recommendations. And for example, here at the office, that's the office of the French editors. So they're listening to hundreds of albums per week, and then they choose, they pick the favorite ones, and they decide which ones we're going to push on the service in France. And we have editors like this in more than 55 countries around the world. In here, there are all different departments of the marketing team, the marketing direction, with all the CRM team here, and the community management, the customer support service, and here all the marketing data, the marketing analysis, and then the studio is here to support the brand. Here to support the brand. Only here, that's the playground of all the developers. They're all specialized in different areas. So there is the payment team here, developers specialized in the big data usage, different support of different mobile supports, platforms, iOS, Android. And then we have also the developers who worked exclusively for all the partnerships we have with manufacturers and with telecom carriers. Mm-hmm. So they're totally dedicated. Once we launch new partnerships, they work closely with the developers and the telco carriers in order to create and share the API together. Mm-hmm. And we regularly organize hackathon here also in order to boost the creativity and either internally or externally, we invite other developers and where we try to invent the new features of Deezer for the next couple of months or something like this.
What is this room about?
This is the room, actually, that's the main room of the developers, totally dedicated to developers. So every time they have a new project, they show this on the TV and they exchange their new ideas. So this is where also the new ideas after a hackathon are presented. But here we have all the support team, so all the financial department, the merger and acquisition department, and the human resources. Merger and acquisition is becoming a big part for us. US or other countries, or in Germany, for example, where we just partnered with Empire. I mean, we just bought Empire, who was part of the ProSieben big media house in Germany. And so we transferred all the database from Empire to Deezer, and then doing a deal with Vodafone in Germany. So this all includes a kind of a merger and acquisition mentality. So this is why we opened this, and now we're going to develop more and more this kind of partnerships with either telecom carriers or media, big media companies in different countries. So here we have two very important teams that are the legal team and the music acquisition team. So they're constantly talking to the labels in order to be able to clear the rights to distribute music on the platform in 182 countries where we are. And also every time we do a deal with telecom carriers or with manufacturers like Samsung in Turkey, for example, we have to talk to the labels in order to clear the rights. So and now we're moving to a very important department, which is the artist marketing department. As you know, we have we're not only a smart jukebox, we have 55 music editors around the world, and they are here to gather all the editorial actions that we do either locally or globally.
We're coming to the entrance now, the recreational area.
Yeah.
So I think
the recreational and the family area, I would say.
Family area.
Yeah, because this is both the cafeteria and also the location where we shoot the Deezer sessions. So it's both the creative area. It's also very creative because this is where all the developers showed your after hackathons their new creations. But also the living place where we eat together, where you can have a coffee, where you can have anything you want.
You have a wonderful garden.
Yeah, that's
over there. Shall we check it?
Yeah, sure. Very big privilege to have a terrace like this, very green, a lot of trees, which is not very common in Paris. And this is also where we organize different parties with partners like labels, where we summer party, the winter party, Christmas party.
Here, and you're sure that people can focus?
I think so, because it really changes actually from the usual meeting room where it's very dark and where people can get bored and not listen to you anymore. I mean, you're here, you're outside, you breathe the air, and you are. It's much more intimate, I would say.
Okay, Matthew, thanks a lot for this gorgeous tour. Actually, it was awesome. Deezer's office is awesome. Deezer itself is awesome. Thank you.
Thank you, bro. My pleasure.
Sevgili ve biraz izleyicileri, Deezer'ın Paris'teki ofisini birlikte ziyaret ettik. Bir başka Paris ofisinde görüşeceğiz. Hoşça kalın.